Hello everyone, in this video, I will show you how to install Ubuntu in a VirtualBox. Let's take a look at the minimal requirements we'll need before getting started. 4 GB of RAM, 25 GB of free disk space, 2 CPU cores, an Ubuntu ISO image file, and the VirtualBox application.
So let's get started.
First, head over to the official Ubuntu website and hover over to get Ubuntu, then click on the Download Ubuntu Desktop button. I will download the 24.04 LTS latest version, which is 64-bit architecture. Make sure to select the appropriate architecture depending on your system requirements. Once the download is complete, the ISO will be saved to the downloaded directory. As you can see, I've already downloaded and installed VirtualBox on my PC. For details, check out my VirtualBox installation guide video. The video link's description is below, and the information card is at the top. Now, let's create a new virtual machine in VirtualBox. Click on the New button. In the name field, type Ubuntu. The default folder will contain your desired virtual machine, but you can choose to move it to another folder. Leave the ISO image field empty for now. Choose Linux as the type and Ubuntu 64-bit as the version, then click on the Next button. On the next screen, you can specify the hardware for the virtual machine. Define the RAM and CPUs that the virtual machine should have. For now, let's go with 4 GB of memory and 4 processors. Click on the Next button. Next, you can define the amount of hard drive space you want for your virtual machine. The default is 25 GB, but you can change it to 40 GB and then click Next. Finally, review the summary of all your selections. Click on Finish at the bottom to complete the process. Before starting the virtual machine, let's adjust some settings. First, go to Settings, and then navigate to General Settings. In the Advanced tab, choose Bidirectional from the Share Clipboard and Drag and Drop drop-down menu. Next, navigate to System Settings and select the Motherboard tab. Uncheck the Floppy option in the Boot Order settings. You can change the 4 GB base memory from here. In the Processor tab, ensure that the CPU is not less than 2 and that the execution cap is at 100%. Also, make sure to check the Enable PE/NX option to improve virtual machine processor performance. In the Display settings, select the Screen tab and choose VBox SVGA, then increase the video memory to 128 MB for better display. Under Storage settings, choose Empty, then select the ISO image file from the optical drive by navigating to the File Location folder. Set the USB to version 3.0. Finally, click OK to save the changes once you're done. After clicking Start, the virtual machine will begin the installation process. You'll see the Welcome to Ubuntu display window on the screen. Please choose the language that suits you best. I will select English as my default language. Accessibility in Ubuntu remains unaltered and continues to progress. I selected the default English US keyboard layout, but you can customize it. I will choose not to connect to the internet. I will then select Install Ubuntu and choose Interactive Installation. For apps, I will choose the default selection. I will avoid selecting Install Recommended Software for now. You can choose from here if you want to. Next, I will choose to erase the disk and install Ubuntu. After that, I will create a user account by filling in the username and choosing the account password. Then, I will select a time zone that matches my time and proceed with the installation. Once it finishes, I'll click Restart to proceed. After restarting, the screen will prompt me to remove the installation medium and then press Enter. I can do this by going into the Devices menu, selecting Optical Drives, and removing the disk from the virtual drive. If it freezes, it means it has already been removed. I'll press the Enter key to proceed. After that, the Welcome to Ubuntu OS screen will display. I will then configure my preferred settings by clicking Next. I will skip enabling Ubuntu Pro for now and choose not to share system data. I will complete the setup by clicking on the Finish button. The Ubuntu 24.04 LTS OS has been successfully installed in VirtualBox. The display screen and the virtual machine screen sizes don't match. You can adjust the screen size using the View menu without installing VirtualBox Guest Editions if you follow my video instructions from the beginning until now. On the View menu, select Virtual Screen to adjust your screen resolution. You can adjust the size of your screen anytime you want a different display. To automatically adjust the virtual screen display to match your host display screen, select Auto Resize Guest Display. For Full Screen Mode, go to the View menu and select Full Screen Mode. To exit Full Screen Mode, go to the bottom menu, select View, and click Full Screen Mode to return to the display screen. That concludes the video. Thanks for watching.
If you like this video, subscribe, like, turn on notifications, and share it.